let's get cracking.
Welcome, everybody, to the Dota 2 Champions League Season 3 playoffs. We got Relax facing up against Power Rangers in a good old-fashioned CIS matchup. So after a lot of Eastern Dota, we now get into the CIS scene, which is always full of fun, exciting things to be able to cast. So let's jump right into the draft, guys. I can go ahead and welcome in my co-caster. Rio Burrow is going to be joining me once again on the mic. What's going on, man?
Nothing much. Glad to be here.
You survived through your storm that you had going on?
Yeah. Nice. I was talking to my grandma. She was like, I was asking her, did you wake up? And she said, yeah. I was like, well, how was it when that light, the electricity off? She was like, it was like dead silent. She's like, kind of creepy. So that happened. But it was okay. We survived. I'm here.
Well, I'm glad you survived the storm, man, because now you get to co-cast with me.
No!
Oh, I know. You love it. You love it. I know you do. So let's go ahead. Get into the draft, shall we? We got, first of all, the Batrider, Terrain Protector, Invoker, and the Lycan. We're all banned away in the first phase. We had the Brewmaster, Sand King, picked up by Relax. You're doing fine. Massive team fight for them. Power Rangers opt to pick up the Mirana as well as the Nature's Prophet. So presumably two of their cores already being revealed. Shadow Demon as well as the Viper were being banned away by Relax. Viper definitely seeing a lot more action than he did a month ago, while the Disruptor and Ancient Apparition banned away by Power Rangers.
And if also people don't notice that there's a DC from Relax's side, I think Stand In Solo. So we're going to be having a remake after these. So don't panic when everybody just starts disconnecting and stuff. Oh. And...
Yeah. Glad you said that. I had no idea. I was talking to Toby while we were starting this thing off.
Making it aware for you, too.
Thank you. Thank you, sly W.
Well, I mean, they got the Brewmaster and the Sand King. That's kind of greedy for the Sand King. We always talk about it. But the Brewmaster, I love the hero. I think it should be... I think it's one of those heroes that can get banned in the first phase now. And also the Nature's Prophet. We've been seeing both of these heroes doing a lot of work recently.
Yeah, Nature's Prophet, especially in the European qualifiers, Virtus Pro running that multiple times to great success, was definitely entertaining finals, to say the least. We got Dazzle now going the way of Relax. You're doing fine, so they get themselves a nice little defensive support. We'll be able to work well with the Sand King, the Burrow Strike, into Shadow Wave, Poison Touch. They got themselves a decent little combo there. Nothing too major, though. Just really more team fight. It's really what it comes down to with the weave, with the shell grave, and everything else. More incentive for Relax to force some team fights. And we'll see whether or not. I'm interested to see if they're going to grab an extra initiator, just go full on mass initiation, and get themselves the axe for the offlane in the hands of Shachalo.
That would be a really nice pickup for Relax. I'm trying to figure out what can they do to counteract the Brewmaster. Like, I keep thinking, what can counter this hero? I think Razor, I've been saying that too. I think it's a really good hero. It could be really useful in their lineup. You could also put Mirana mid with maybe a Bane or something. Mm-hmm. But I think this hero gets too much in the middle lane if you don't try to shut it down. And well, there's going to be that, but that's just a couple up with the Mirana arrow. And this Nature's Prophet, I'm going to be wondering if he's going to be picking up a mech so they can survive these team fights early in the game.
Yeah, the Bane for me, it's still a good setup hero, obviously, for the arrow. And I suppose it's good control, possibly, for the Brewmaster. But I'm honestly a little bit puzzled that they banned away the Disruptor just because he's such a good counter to Brewmaster, possibly even the Sand King as well. But more about the Brewmaster. You know, he sees, like, that AoE silence, trying to get that instant silence down on the Brewmaster before he actually pops that ultimate. I'm surprised PR didn't try and pick that up for them spells, but of course they didn't have first pick coming into the second phase. And Relax, well, they're not going to get the axe, but they get something that Shachalo is equally familiar with. They get the Centaur Warrunner for him.
Well, Disruptor counters Mirana pretty hard, too. It's never fun playing Mirana when you play against that hero.
True.
So Centaur, and they're going to have a lot of tanky heroes. Power Rangers, they... might get run over this game, but if they have a good laning stage, they might be able to survive. Like I said, Nature's Prophet, he might have to go mech this game if he wants his team to be surviving these team fights. I think they should get a Kunkka here for Power Rangers or something along the lines. Maybe a DK. They need a frontliner, another tank. And if they don't get one, I don't see them contesting any of these team fights.
What about the Wraith King? Either as a support or as a actual core here. I just got done finishing up a game where the Wraith King, being able to have those double lives, made a big difference when going up against those kind of like wombo combo strats. Like after when they initiate, right, they throw down all that damage. The Wraith King dies. He ends up slowing everybody. Comes back ready to fight again. What about something like that?
Yeah, you need two heroes though, so you can get that, and then maybe a mid hero. Because you need two tanks, because you're going to have one of them is going to be disabled from the ulti. And you should also get two BKB heroes here so they can utilize the efficient, like, Brewmaster's not going to be as effective if you just get two BKB heroes here. And they can hopefully survive the late game, because right now, Relax, they have a really strong early game. And they had the last pick, which they can shore up even late game maybe. Because we've seen the Centaur carry some games. All you need is like a heart or Shivas, and it's unstoppable to kill.
Well, DK is another hero that's kind of in my mind right now, but they give themselves a little bit of spam here with the Keeper of the Light. A pretty good turtling support hero, but obviously super, super open to initiation. Zan King, Brewmaster, any of those guys are going to be more than happy to be able to jump on a Caudle and clean him up real quickly. So his positioning is going to have to be superb this game, because there's so many Blink Dagger heroes on the side of Relax. I'm not feeling too confident about Power Rangers right now. I do agree with you. I thought they were going to be looking at like the Dragonite for the mid and maybe a Wraith King. Hell, even run Mirana as a support, and then you have a whole bunch of options when it comes to tanky heroes when you open up that extra core slot.
Yeah, I think they need a Mirana, like you're saying, as a support, because you brought it up. The Blink Daggers are going to be, you can't split push. That's the whole point of their lineup, is kind of like, all right, we're going to be split pushing with Caudle and Nature's Prophet. So how are you going to split push when they have three Blinks? Like you're saying, it's going to be easy to get pick-offs, but they still have the Mirana ulti and the Bane maneuverability around, so they can get some nice pick-offs on their own from Power Rangers' side. It's just, can they do enough in the early stages of the game right now to where they're not going to be falling behind and giving up these quick Blink Daggers?
Mm-hmm. So real quick, guys, I just want to go over what exactly this game is. I know I mentioned it was the playoffs earlier, but this is the round one of the playoffs. If you haven't actually been paying attention to the Dota 2 Champions League and how that format works, it's basically there were two different groups. So we had a group stage. The top teams go automatically into the semifinals. So right now, Empire and Alliance are waiting in the semifinals. In the quarterfinals, we have Evil Geniuses and Fnatic waiting on the different side of the brackets. And we have Relax versus PR for today. Later on, we're going to be casting. In fact, tomorrow, we've got Na'Vi versus RoxKiss. So that's going to be going on tomorrow. That should be one hell of an interesting game as well. So for those of you guys who aren't aware of the playoffs and how this works, that's how it's going to happen. You can also check out joindota.com. We have our little match ticker. You just click on the tournament, and you can go check it out for yourself. Remaining. But now we see the Slark is going to be picked up for Relax. You're doing fine. I feel that's like just kind of perfect. Extra survivability. But, interesting. Power Rangers get themselves a Timber Saw. So they don't get themselves a big tank. They don't get themselves a BKB hero. But they do get a hero that's really effective against every single one of the Relax You're Doing Fine boys.
Right. And it's going to be on Timber Saw to make a lot of space, along with the Mirana. So we'll see if they can split push. And if this Timber Saw does get a fast Bloodstone, he might be able to carry this game. But as it stands right now, we'll see if it's enough, because the Slark, like I said, this Nature's Prophet is going to be having a hard time being useful this game, so he might have to go a fast mechanism or some other kind of utility item. We'll see what he wants to do.
And this really feels like if you're on the edge about Blink Dagger and how effective that is for Slark, I think this is one of those games where even if you're on the edge, you pick up a Blink Dagger on Slark, because just the mass initiation, we already talked about how effective it's going to be versus all these guys, but you've got certain heroes that are really shut down by Slark. For example, Mirana, if you blink in, you get the pounce on her, she can't leap away, right? She's still really squishy. She obviously, she normally does not build into a BKB, or at least early on, so that kind of limits how you're going to be able to play with that one. So that's a quick, easy hero kill. We got the Keeper of Light, who has no escape mechanisms, who's easily going to be picked off by the Slark over and over and over again. And what other squishy heroes did we have? And there's another support. There was a... what else was there on the side of Power Rangers?
Sand King Dazzle.
No, I'm sorry.
Or was it right.
PR, you're thinking of Relax.
Okay.
Relax. They're on Dire.
So that's Sand King. And then, the other one's Bane, Potom. And
Bane, that's right. Okay, Bane. Another easy hero kill. And then their cores were also pretty squishy. I short-term memory, man. Too many games.
Nature's Prophet.
Well, yeah, Nature's Prophet, another easy kill. Anyway, the point being the Blink Dagger is going to be super strong.
Gave it to me. Wow.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to.
That was Coddle.
Please forgive.
That hero.
Yeah.
Well, I forgive you. But another thing to notice is that Slark's been being picked up a lot recently. I think it's just because Doom and Shadow Demon's been banned out a lot. Those heroes do really well against it. Just the counter-initiation and the Purge is really good. Mm-hmm. Also, the Doom just counterjacks that hero. So every time we see, like, normally the Doom banned out in the second phase, it opens up a lot of the second phase or last phase, or you can say the third phase, for these pickups of the Slark. And it's a really good hero, as long as it doesn't get silenced, which they have no silences right now on Power Rangers. Mm-hmm.
The one good thing that they do have on Power Rangers is that the mass AoE nukes coming out from the Timbersaw. That is actually pretty effective against the Slark. You can't rely on just shadow dancing at the last second because you can still be cleaned up. And the Whirling Death is going to be super effective against three of the heroes. Sand King, Centaur, and Brewmaster all going to be susceptible to that stat reduction. And the other two are just squishy in general. So Timbersaw's got to have a great game here, I think, for Power Rangers to win this. That is their only hope, in my mind.
Yeah, hopefully he won't get shut down. And if he does get shut down, maybe the Murano will rotate and free up some space for him. Otherwise, like you said, it's going to be really hard for them because Brewmaster middle, he's going to be... I mean, that hero is just because of the changes. He just gets a lot out of the mid lane now. It's really hard to just crush him in the laning phase. Mm-hmm. So he's going to be doing a lot this game. And Centaur, safe lane, going to be doing a lot apparently because they're going aggro. No, dual aggro? Confused.
I can't believe if they are going in aggro, this is pretty greedy of them. Like, they're dealing with a Bane Murana with a Keeper of the Light, three ranged heroes versus two melees that don't have great initiation tools. Like, both Pounce and Burrow Strike early on are not going to be the be-all, end-all of initiation, right? They only go, like... Well, first of all, Burrow Strike only goes 350 range. Pounce probably goes 450, maybe 500. 700. What? Oh, my God. Pounce. 700 range. Are you serious?
Yeah, man. It's really good. I think they can kill Caudle in this lane, but they'll give up some kills as well. Oh, double damage already.
Oh, Jesus.
Burrow Strike. Oh, J4. 100. 200,
he's
going to
be copping a ton of damage here. FNG. Sleep. Here's the arrow. Oh, they're going to get a kill on Dread. The arrow, 5-second arrow into the 2-second blast, and Dread is going to be giving away the first blood. It was all part of the plan, Ryu. It was all a part of the plan.
Hey, the first hit was like 104 damage, the next hit was like 83, and then the last one was like 74. I was kind of disappointed in those hits. Maybe if they're all hundreds, he could have got the kill. So, other than that, yeah, they're just playing really too greedy there from the Sand King. You should have known that the backup was going to be coming.
Maybe they thought it was going to be an aggro try, and that they were trying to dodge it. That for me makes a lot more sense, which explains why they'd be going back to this top defensive position now that they see the Furion in lane. And Shotchlow is now going to be running at this bottom lane. He's still got to be really careful, though, because the sleep arrow combo, especially once they pick up level 2, level 3, and he's still sitting at measly level 1. That's just free farm for Moon.
Well, a good hero that I like to go against is a Timbersaw versus a Panda. I think this is a really good matchup for Timbersaw. He won't just get crushed, and he can do a lot of work, too. So I like this matchup because I was wondering what would they try to do against it. And Keeper Light, he's farming up the jungle quite nicely as well. So
Yeah, all in all, Power Rangers, yeah, I mean, you could talk a lot about the team fight potential of Relax and how much firepower that they have, but it doesn't really matter if they lose the laning phase really hard, which it looks like that's exactly what's about to happen. They're going to win every single lane. Cheshire Cat's doing well at the offlane. The mid, Timbersaw versus any sort of strength melee is going to be doing pretty good for him. And obviously, this defensive dual lane is just going to wreck the Centaur, and they just have the added bonus of Keeper of Light farming up the jungle. So, all in all, things starting out well for Power Rangers.
Yeah, and they already stacked the jungle, so Centaur's down here. He can't even do anything. I mean, he's just going to get demolished, and he has to get return here. He's going to have to start jungling, so this is very unfortunate for him. Because you can't go bottom lane, else you're going to die. And Dread's not level 2 yet, so his Sandstorm, he doesn't have it, so he's useless in the jungle right now. And it's just not looking good right now for Relax.
Well, hopefully they're just going to be able to survive throughout the laning phase. Slark gets, it's his basic, whatever his item choice is going to be. I got to say Shadowblade or Blink Dagger. I think you have to go for one of the two aggressive pickups. I honestly don't mind either one, even though I do really side with Blink Dagger here. Just watching in the last few days, especially in the European qualifier, I'm giving Blink Dagger another look on Slark, and I think this is one of those games where it's going to be mega effective.
This game, it might be I don't know if it's a Midas game. I don't know what he's going to go. Because if you think about it, they have to wait for their blink on Panda and blink on Centaur, or at least Centaur to get 6 before they can do a lot. So, and that's going to be a while. So is he going to have it in time before he gets the Blink Dagger? I doubt it. So he might go Midas this game just so he can get those extra levels, get that extra farm, and it wouldn't be too bad.
And it makes sense considering how much Relax are probably going to be grouping up, looking for kills, pushing down towers, that a Midas really helps you keep that gold advantage. Even though you're not spending much time farming. So I would like that decision as well. Cheshire Cat moving down to the bottom lane. Looks like they're going to start an early push here. Phase Boots on Moon as well, so the additional physical damage plus the Ring of Bacillus being turned active. They got themselves a very early push lineup that Relax can't really deal with yet.
Right, and there's a double damage bottom. I'm going to save that for the Timbersaw here. Or Dread might die again trying to go for this. But they have a ward both seeing. Well, that's an easy steal for the Sand King on the DD, but he's not going to go for it.
FNG is going to spy out Dread here, running himself away with the boots. He's going to run it right into the Centaur, though. Stomp will land the follow-up Burrow Strike. And now with the Shadow Wave, that should be a fairly easy kill for them. FNG sacrifices his life, but the rest of his team does get that tier 1 tower.
That's a kill pause right there.
Uh-huh.
It really
was. Not everybody is Ryob. All right. Not everyone.
No, look, they instantly unpause. Come on now. But they got the tower, like you said, bottom lane, and now they got the double damage on Timbersaw. Timbersaw, maybe he wants more in Timber Change. I know this is normally the build, but if you get initiated on with a clap and then an ulti, if you only have one in Timber Chain, it's going to be really hard for you to get away in this mid lane.
Yeah, that's a good point. I mean, considering the fact that the heavy crits Brewmaster, like, he gets, it's the antithesis of reactive armor, right? The more hits you get, the less physical damage you're going to be taking as time goes on. Whereas Brewmaster has the just sit around, wait for a drunken brawler to give you a free crit, and that first hit is going to be going up against the Timbersaw, who has one armor. Is one armor for that first hit. So there's actually a large amount of burst damage coming out from this Brewmaster. Scandal does have to play this pretty carefully if he doesn't get some extra levels in the chain.
Right. Caudle is going to be coming up here, putting up some aggressive wards so they can scout the rotations of the support. So nicely played by him. He can also stop this push that's out to be coming from the Slark. So he's already 4.5. He'll hit level 5 up here. So that's really early levels on a Caudle. 4-6 minutes.
And his anti-pushing power. That means like that little bit of push that came in from the bottom lane. Relax won't be able to even out that tower lead. Like, they won't be able to push out this off lane unless they get a really good pickoff and turn that into like 3 or 4 heroes beating on the tower. They'd have to go behind the tier 1, catch out the Keeper of the Light, and turn that into a quick push. Otherwise, J4 is just going to constantly spam out those Illuminate Blasts that will be forcing back the wave time and time again. So overall, it seems like Power Rangers, I don't think we gave them as much credit on how well their laning phase is really going to go when we're talking about the draft.
Yeah, I think it comes down to not the first blood either. If they give up the first blood, it would have been maybe a little bit better. There was no way for them to really zone out the Furion as well. Mm-hmm. So it was nice that they put the Timbersaw mid, because we weren't really thinking about the lanes too much. We didn't have that much time, because when you have this re-pick, there's a lot less time. Like, what is it, 30 seconds or so?
Yeah. So. Yeah. And there's also the gap of, what heroes were there again? I can't remember. So, I blame the number of games today. That's what I blame. What do you blame it on, Ryu? Huh? It's your first cast of the day.
I blame it on my workout. Didn't get pumped up enough.
Need to get more pumped up.
Need more juices. Need some more Monster Energy. Is that our drink? No, you said you don't have a drink sponsor.
No. Join Dota, though. No. We do have
I'll help
in
you.
The office, though.
We could take some. What's a good one? Nest tea?
No, I don't.
Just kidding.
Can we get sponsored by, like, orange juice?
That's what orange juice?
That's what I want to be sponsored by. Just an orange juice company.
It's already Orange Esports. No, that's without
so
Mushi.
This will be Orange Juice,
man.
Esports.
No Mushi, no win.
Wait. Orange Juice Esports.
Wow, just lost a courier. I bet you didn't get that.
No, I didn't. Cheshire Cat is probably going to die for it here. Shachlo's running right next to him. He doesn't actually have enough for a stomp. Windex. Come on, Windex.
Already, though.
You can get close enough for... Well, this is going to be a lot of wasted time, to say the least. Look at him. Like, is it even necessary, Dread, for you to be running a Cheshire Cat, too? Like, I know you probably want to be part of the experience, but that was just, honestly, totally worth it for Cheshire Cat, even if he didn't get the courier. He just wasted four people's time.
And Midas, like I was saying, he picked it up before he died, like 30 seconds before he died, to be approximate. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Yeah, a lot of time wasted, and he can always TP back to his bottom lane and cause havoc. He's got the ulti, so they have to worry some about that. This is going to be another tier 2 going down unless they have... Well, Shadow Priest is coming. Maybe he won't die.
They don't have the Centaur ultimate, though. Like without the blink, obviously, Centaur pretty gimped. But then you also don't have your Centaur ultimate. Now there's just no chance of you initiating at all. So it's either like the bottom tower or the middle tower, because that's where Power Rangers are pushing with the Furion right now. Yoki's got to be a little bit careful there with that burst damage. At the same time, well, he does have a lot of magic wand charges. Maybe he can actually bait something out, get a clap into the Brewmaster ultimate. Be a little risky, but they need to start fighting soon, because these towers are just being chipped away bit by bit.
And Sand King's level 6 already. He cleared like a triple stack already. So he's back into this game pretty easily. And he's got his Blink Dagger and 500 or 50 gold. And Brewmaster has his already. They didn't get that tier 1 tower mid either. So, but Slash.
Yeah, Shachlo's done for. Really good pull there from FNG running to the left, to the side, to actually make sure that the creeps were dragged away. A good leap as well from the Mirana. Now leaves the middle lane open. Timbersaw may not be the greatest physical damage. At level 9, he's hitting for 69 average damage. But by God, he's going to be able to finish off this tower anyway. Can't even get the deny from Dread. And now Dread's got to get out of here. Picks up his Blink Dagger.
Because of the Whirling Death. That was so funny.
Uh-oh. Now the turnaround.
The coming in.
Clap's going to come in. Yoki not popping the ultimate there. And that actually means Scandal's going to get away. If he popped the ultimate, he would have been able to get the stun out in time, but now they missed out on that kill. They don't have the rotations to be able to stop this top tower push. The list goes on and on and on.
And the bottom tower, too. So they're going to decide probably just to defend the bottom tier, too. So they're just getting split up right now, and it's not looking good for them because they don't have a really good way to really push out these lanes faster. I mean, like, get towers. They can push out the lanes pretty fast, but not as fast as Power Rangers. So yeah, it's a little bit unfortunate.
Once they have the Blink Daggers, everything changes for Relax. They actually have a lineup that's really good at being able to deal with all this split push. But it's just the early game seems to stretch on and on as Relax continue to be deprived of gold on some of their key heroes. At least Yoki has his Blink Dagger, but Centaur still lacking his. Slark did go for a Blink Dagger of his own, so that was his item choice.
Yeah, we even have Caudle picking up a...
I love that pickup.
The Blink Dagger. But what I was saying earlier is the Whirling Death, that's why he missed the deny on the Whirling Death, because he took his strength, which takes his, his attack damage down too.
I didn't
think
so
he missed
that.
The deny, because that was really unfortunate.
Smoke up. Do have a haste run. Lead with the Broshek. Now the follow-up. Jesus.
That's
all right. That was overkill.
That was overkill. Jinx. Yo, you owe me something. I'll take a drink right about now.
Well, I could use a drink as well. Many drinks.
Oh.
Take alcoholic some, drinks.
Alcoholic drinks.
But I'm not getting those, so neither are you.
Wow.
Yeah, the epicenter being committed there.
Communism?
Convicted.
Congestion? I don't know.
Congestion? He done got congestionated.
Yep, they were all...
Goddamn Rio Burrows. That southern accent.
They were all right there. They were all congestionated together or something. I'm just making up my words now. Congestionated. I'm capped now.
Mm-hmm. We're going to wait for this haste rune for Brewmaster. Yoki's going to use it somewhere. He's going to use it somewhere to get a pickoff. I have faith. The problem is, the heroes that he's looking at right now, like you got the Moran at the bottom lane, who has the leap, plus Moonlight Shadow. Like the mid lane, you've got the Timbersaw. So your actual jump in, clap, you need a stun to be able to lock down these heroes. That's one thing that Power Rangers did a very good job is being
able
to get themselves.
They got this Blink Dagger on the Slark, and he doesn't need it.
Now the leap goes out, but he won't go anywhere. The clap goes out. FNG tries in futility to help out his ally.
Stun
Why? Shachalu's going to die almost because his allies refute to help him out there. That was a full Fiend's Grip for no reason. Now FNG gets dropped back down. Shachalu turns. Slark coming. Why? Oh my god, what is Slark doing? They get the clap. They finally kill the Bane, but that should have been two quick, easy kills with nobody dying. And somehow they screw it up and Slark ends up going down.
Yeah, that was a pretty big misplay from the Panda there, costing his ally. I don't understand why he didn't cancel the Fiend's Grip. Either cancel it with the Cyclone immediately, or because he stunned the bottom, you could just cancel it with that. I don't know. Just not really well executed there. So in the end, one for one, and their ultis are down. So, I mean, this Bane, holy cow. He's got an Ogre Axe, and he's 1,200 gold, so he's going to be rushing that BKB. Once he gets that, then Relax is going to be having a hard time stopping him. But...
they're going to go for a try to kill on Moon. Beautiful bait there. Hey, at least this time, well, they still have a hard time killing Moon just because he has so many levels and has a decent number of stats from drums and that sort of thing. But finally, they do kill him. They can get themselves away. Oh, well, that's part of the problem. Shachalu's. Hey, he only has level 1 Hoofstomp still.
Yeah, I was like wondering, why didn't that do any damage? I was just like, so he's not doesn't have that many levels. Bloodstone about to be picked up here from Scandal, and this is really nice timing here. They're going to be having a hard time dealing with him now.
Yeah, as long as this first fight goes well for them and he gets a bunch of charges, he's going to be sitting real pretty in all of that regen.
He doesn't even need a TP down here. They can get the recall. What? The Caudle is level 8 and doesn't have a recall. That.
Well,
it's kind of weird.
He's being a mega split pusher, man. He went for the Quelling Blade plus Blink Dagger.
He's a farmer, not a team helper. He's a capitalist. Got him.
And I admire it. I admire it. Because he can build himself a point booster already after the Blink Dagger and the Quelling Blade. Look at him digging a little hole in here.
Yeah, he's got the 6th highest CS. That's pretty good. 56 CS at 15 minutes as a support. That's pretty amazing.
Dread, he knows. He knows Keeper of Light is somewhere around here. Blinks away just in time. Now the Moonlight Shadow. They see FNG trying to kill Dread. Gets a good Shallow Grave to be able to save him. But the result is the Dazzle goes down and... Bane also going to go down on the side here. Slug should be able to finish him off, but they're in a bad position nonetheless. Brewmaster, yeah, all Power Rangers circling in on that Slark. Fortunately, was able to blink away. Relax just completely overextended themselves in that situation.
Right, that was just a really well played. Power Rangers are just way too far ahead. They shouldn't be trying to go on them. They didn't know that he had a Bloodstone, and then they got really out of position there. So, diving a tier 1 tower isn't really the best bet, but they're kind of forced to do that because they're just going to get split pushed. So if they don't start taking these team fights or trying to make something happen, either get the pickoff. Oh, there's a pickoff maybe on Moon.
Oh, yeah. Moon's going to go down here. Can't teleport away. That was just an extra waste.
Still not getting towers, though. So, I mean, Power Rangers are doing fine, even though they're down 3 kills. They're winning pretty heavily. They've got a 7,000 gold lead. It's stat line, but, or whatever that's called.
Yes.
Stagnated.
I don't know. That's not the word you're looking for. I know.
What's the term? Yeah, the doctor term.
Yeah, the doctor
term. Flatline.
Flatline. Yeah.
Yes.
Yes. Dire's middle tower. Yes, that's exactly what it's.
Answer
done.
My own question. You're useless. I don't need you.
Tier 1 tower is going to fall at bottom lane. Relax. Are going to be able to take that down, but it looks like it's going to come at a fight as Power Rangers are going to be making those rotations in, teleport in. Oh, we caught out Dread with that. That whirling death, now he's going to be able to kill up a Shotch though real quick. And now the additional blink in, J4. He wanted to get the mana drain.
They can run away.
Yeah. Mana leak.
Well, Sinsar doesn't have a blink dagger, that's the biggest problem they're having right now. That's why he can't run away with his tails between his legs. Very unfortunate. Maybe he could live there. Because you can blink out of the Sprout.
Shadowblade was picked up by Shishir Cat. Can't say I'm too surprised. Right, you got to build this Furion into a semi-carry, just in case this game goes too late. You don't want Murata to be your only carry.
Right. Relax. I mean, they still haven't gotten the tower. That's the biggest concern still. And they're just getting split pushed, like we keep talking about. So this is really good. For Power Rangers for right now, but I don't know if this goes late game. Blacks have a decent lineup, but I mean, this, you could just count this Timbersaw as a carry in this situation because there's gonna be no way Relax can kill him. What do they do? They just use Cyclone? That's the only thing I can see them doing. Yeah. Just putting him out of the fight.
Might be their best hope. So going into, I don't know, maybe they just farm up the Aghanims, wait for that upgrade for them. Scandal's just dipping around the jungle, clearing through trees. Been a speed a little bugger, no problem. Moon just continues the farm. Once again, it's going to be a signature carry Moon Murana.
Do you know the best part about that is, like, even if he gets gone on, I don't even think, all right, they have 2 stuns. At the end of the day, I don't think they could still kill him because he could just suicide with Bloodstone. That's how like unkillable he is right now.
Yeah. Can't even.
They need 4 or 5 heroes.
We're going to have a wraparound here from Relax. They've already placed a bunch of really aggressive wards. They're not actually catching out the lane. Instead, they're going to find Scandal, which could be a good kill, but we just talked about the fact how tanky he is. Dread is actually in a really bad position. Going to be caught out by the Fiend's Grip. Yoki blinks in here, pops a clap. Now the follow-up ultimate goes down. Fortunately, the arrow lands on the Fire Panda, limiting all of the damage they can throw out. FNG still going to go down. The Broolings got to get themselves out of here. As the Slark also going to be on the retreat. Top lane, we did have Cheshire Cat picking off the Centaur War Runner again. Poor guy cannot get his Blink Dagger to save his life.
Alright, Timbersaw is the best hero against Brewmaster. I'm picking this hero every game against him now. Because this pure damage from Timber Chain in the Chakram just rapes the panda. Well, FN got arrowed to the face, but he's going to live. Top though, Cheshire Cat not going to be so lucky.
Yo, the epicenter being committed. He tried to teleport out. He really did. But he didn't quite make it. 8 to 10, 20
Moon.
And a half minutes in,
Moon.
And jump in on Moon. He's seen this come time and time again. He does get off the Moonlight Shadow, gets away from the Poison Touch in time. Well played, and this actually may be a counter kill. Arrow's gonna be able to somehow go right between the Dazzle and the Slark and hit the creep in the background. That was rather lucky. What is Scandal building into? Scythe of Ice? Lincoln's? Probably not Lincoln's. Probably Scythe.
Whatever he wants. I mean, probably Shiva's. A Manta on a Timbersaw? Alright. Alright, well, this cast just got got one-sided. So I'll let you guys know when I see the Timbersaw with a Manta. I think I'm going to retire Dota.
Yeah. I will retire casting as well.
Right there with you. What if it happened, though, just because he's listening?
Well, then I would be made a liar because I can't stay in Berlin without a job. So
you could be a hooker. What do they call it?
No,
there?
I can't, actually.
What?
They kick me out if I don't have a job.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Can't you be a hooker over there? Is that legal?
No, I mean, I think you probably can. I don't.
Yeah, that's a job. Probably sell yourself.
Probably isn't proper stream conversation, but I don't care because what happens in Germany is that you actually have to prove.
Stays in Germany.
You have to prove that the job that you have, that you are more qualified for it than any German that could want the job. So
really?
Basically, when I come in for this job, they actually had to have open
tryouts.
They basically had to post somewhere that they're like, "Hey, we got this commentator job." Cheshire Cat got picked off in bottom lane. Hey, we had this commentator job, and then whoever applies can apply if they want to, and they can possibly sue. So radiant structures. They'd be like, they chose an American over a German. Dyer's top tower has not any better than me. Radiant's bottom tower. So they'd have to prove I was better than him. Top lane, we have the Brewmaster ultimate going off. Strong scandal. Dredd's waiting for the Burrow Strike. Now the follow-up. No, he's not going to epicenter. Instead, they're just going to focus down Scandal. He's so damn tanky. Is he actually going to be able to get off the die here? He turns around. He's still alive. He's still alive through all of that. The epicenter did nothing from Dredd. I have no idea why he didn't just use it on the Timbersaw. Now he's going to be caught out by an arrow. He's guaranteed to be dead. Shallow Grave will buy him a little bit of time, but he's not getting anywhere. Well, maybe blink. Oh my god, he blinked.
Oh my goodness.
He lived.
No way.
Legit. And Slark now has a Scotty, so small upgrades.
Well, 5v1 Scandal is invincible, confirmed already. And other than that, yeah, like you said, maybe Sand King, if Dredd just got off the epicenter on top of his head, they could have maybe taken him down. But still, that's all their towers now. Gone from Relax's side. I don't think anybody died in that fight. Maybe one from Relax. I'm not exactly sure.
Yeah, there was one hero died.
Nope. I forgot which one. Wasn't.
What is Scandal's mixed bag of goodies he's got here? He's got a Bloodstone, Plate Mail, and a Hood of Defiance. So apparently he doesn't want to feel like finishing up the pipe for the rest of his team. And is going to go into the Shivas as his next item.
Yeah, man. It's a one-man wrecking crew. Doesn't need to help out the team. He is the team.
Apparently. Oh! The BKB activated by FNG. He just grabbed that one, too.
He doesn't have a TP.
And
3, 2, 1,
he's TP. Good. No. He's good. Rest of Relax. They can't chase that far.
They don't know where they're at.
Yeah. They see Moon at bottom, but Furion could be there at any point in time. The rest of heroes could be colliding on them. Moon is actually going to go for a BKB. He's done with the Slark.
They saw Scandal and they ran away. That's what happened.
Much, yeah, pretty much what happened.
Yep. Well, I mean, they're still looking good. Once they get the Sheep Stick on Nature's Prophet, I think they'll be able to contest High Ground. They can do Roshan. Relax has an okay lineup to deal with it. You got the Blink in. But they don't have anything to scout it out. That's the one big problem they have. Oh, they have the... They have the weave, so if they know they're in there, they can use the weave from a far distance, and maybe they could take a team fight around there. But Power Rangers, either they're going to be searching for a pickoff or that being Roshan.
Keeper of the Light was able to finish up his ag, so he is now Gandalf the White.
Well, he's a white and gray, so he's way.
He was Gandalf the Gray, now he's Gandalf.
Yeah, but he's still kind of gray.
No,
he's
shiny.
That.
Look at it. That's a whole bunch of white. Where do you see any gray?
I see gold now that I think about it.
Oh, well, yeah.
Are
you want
right.
him
There's
to
no
be
gray,
completely
gold.
White? Are you complaining at Gandalf? Is it actually Gandalf the White because he's got skin color that's.
You know what I'm going to complain about Gandalf? Oh, wow.
Scandal's
Scandal.
In some trouble. No,
fine.
He's not. Jesus. They only brought him down to half health. That is ridiculous. Well, we do have little bit of extra initiation here from Yoki. May just pop that ultimate finally to kill Scandal. He can pop the Bloodstone, though. I think this time he is going to go down. Maybe not. The stomp doesn't get him. He gets away from the epicenter. Scandal keeps on going. Another Timber Chain through.
1v5.
Oh, my God. Could he actually do it one more? No, he gets stunned up. Should have just denied himself. He wanted to be fancy.
Hey, imagine if he had a BKB. He would have just raped all of them.
He just would have popped the BKB, turned, and said, I am your shiny golden god. Kneel before me.
Yep.
Kneel and well, bow.
They're still getting a lot out of the map, though, more so. And they wasted a lot of time there. I'm surprised nobody came in help. But because since it lasted forever, that chase.
It really did. Fiend's Grip is going to catch out Windex. And pop goes the Weasel. So Scandal gets some of his Bloodstone charges back. And almost has that Shiva that we were talking about.
Yeah, that'll be up in, what is 600-700 goldish. One big problem is still that the Slark is getting bigger. He hasn't gotten anything since his Scotty, though. So that's something to worry about. What can he get? He needs an Abyssal Blade for their heroes. But he also needs kind of a little bit more of attack speed. So I think he'll go for the Abyssal Blade, though. First. Mm-hmm. At least the Basher.
Moon almost has his Yasha. What other items? What other pickups? Keeper of the Light hasn't grabbed anything since his Ags. Kind of surprised with the way he's been farming.
I mean, Cheshire Cat's been holding on to 4,000 gold, so he can buy his Sheepstick. Could have bought it a while ago.
Yeah, he could have bought it quite some time ago. He's just enjoying Hala Hala getting
the farm life.
It's all about
farming
farm
those
life.
Fields. Oh, I'm going to get flack for that.
Furion no longer playing Dota 2.
Oh, the arrow?
Now
no.
Playing Farmville.
So close.
I didn't see it.
Inches. Yeah, what you cannot see. I mean, what can they do? All right, we have Relax. Still, they have great pickoffing potential. But they still have no way to deal with FNG right now, who has a BKB, and they have recalls. So they can't even push out the lanes. Relax, just are going to have to hope that they can get a good pickoff or survive the onslaught. They're just going to keep getting too much, though, from Power Rangers. Mm-hmm. It's farming too much.
Oh, Furion's going to come in from behind. Shachlo! Oh, he got his Blink Dagger, but I don't think he's getting a second item this game. Unless it's going to be all about the Slark. Like, all of this game is on the Slark and his Scotty. And how well he's going to be able to pick off these heroes and carry his team. J4 is actually able to bring in Moon here and gets the Blink away at the same time. He actually got out. Moon's in a little bit of trouble. He can pop the BKB at any time, though. So he should be all right. Holds on to it now. Oh, Dread gets a beautiful Burrow Strike. Snags the Murana. Grabs Scandal as well. Now the BKB going to be activated. There goes the Slark, as there's nothing that's going to be able to stop him. Well, maybe they don't have enough burst damage. Right clicks. Moon got it. He leaps in, is able to get that last hit. FNG still living on the side here. Yoki trying to get himself away. Another good Burrow Strike coming out from Dread. Gotta say, Dread's playing really well so far. Got himself that really fast Blink Dagger, excusing the couple of not so great epicenters. Everything else about his Sand King has been great.
Yeah, they got, I don't want to say lucky, but it's really well played from the Caudle. They're starting off the fight because he used the Blinding Light in the Slark, allowing him to blink out afterwards. Nice pick off from the Bane, getting the Slark. Nothing canceled the BKB, already said that, so. Yeah, it was just a systematic.
Oh, Dread, your time to shine is here, buddy. Epicenter in. Go on FNG. FNG's so tanky.
No stun mana.
Oh, my God. Well, I don't think even if he did have stun mana, I think it would still maybe would have gotten the Bane, and that's it. Centaur goes down on the side. You now have Yoki and Windex coming in. They do have the Brewmaster ultimate. They're going to try and lock down FNG with a clap up in a second, or
Slark
maybe just the right
push. Pick off Furion up here on the top. It's a gem on the floor.
Yeah, gem was dropped back down to the Brewmaster, who pops his ultimate in order to finish off the Murana. So Relax actually somehow win that team fight. They had a couple of buybacks there, I think. At least one on the Slark, as well as one on the Sank. But well worth it in the end. They get the Aegis.
Yeah, and they're prolonging the game. That's what they have to do. Because Relax, they need to find ways to get these pickoffs. So it would just happen. And now they're able to push. Maybe get this tier 1, but... It's going to be hard to kill this. Coddle's up. Radiant's middle tower. Bane's up. Attack. They've got to fortify too. Structures are
fortified. Yeah, things all of a sudden looking not so great for Power Rangers. They were so far ahead in gold and everything else, but it's going to start dipping down. Oh, yeah, over a 15,000 gold lead. Few teams have been able to come back from that kind of advantage.
Yeah, the only thing they got out of that was Roshan and some good kills there. So it's really good for Relax. Maybe one or two more of those, and they can acquire some of these tier ones that's been plaguing them so far. Bad thing is that Centaur might get picked off here. All they have to do is recall one, plus this Furion TP in, and there goes. Nice blink out TP, though.
Well played, and he finally does get that mech, so I was wrong. I was completely wrong, and honestly, this game's a little bit closer than the gold graph would insinuate. Power Rangers still in a good hold of the game, but the biggest issue is Moon has just been totally suffering in farm. Like, he's sitting right in the middle despite the fact he's supposed to be in one position.
Right, and this is one of the games where Power Rangers, they should have went Midas on the bottom as well, and Dredd picked off middle lane. They got the sheep.
They used a BKB for it, though.
He's going to go down, too.
Yeah, they're going to catch him out with the Scotty. Centaur ultimate going off. Windex does get himself away. And Moon is forced to defend this bottom lane, so they're actually not going to be able to turn that into a push, despite the fact they got a pick off on the Sand King, who bought back earlier. So we had a really long death timer. That could have been a good opportunity for them to push uphill, but the split push coming in from Relax will delay that a little bit longer.
Moon didn't need the Midas. I take it back. He needed the Mjolnir, though, because that item wins games, and putting that on the Timbersaw would have been the best situation they could have had. I think Power Rangers could have went high ground as long as they had that. So without that, it's going to be hard. They don't have the Centaur ulti, so I don't think they can kill Moon, even if they catch him. Mm-hmm. It might be close.
Moonlight Shadow goes out. Moon forced to use that defensively there. Relax. They came in with the dust, but our Slark had no intention to go further. He is going to be able to pick up a Basher here in just 60 gold, so that's going to be a big upgrade for them. In fact, he sells just to be able to finish it off. Top tower is under attack. So that is going to be some additional lockdown, very important against the Marana and the Timbersaw, because he can no longer rely on just his pounce to hold in the Marana anymore. He's going to need some extra lockdown.
And FNG going to get initiated on top here. He's getting bashed.
Oh, nice. He does sleep, though. Sleep defensively. Now trying to brain sap as well. Gets a little bit of extra damage on the Slark, but it doesn't matter. Free pickoff, bottom lane.
Shachlo.
Arrow. Oh, Shachlo couldn't teleport away in time. Now Moon. Oh, he missed the Starstorm. He might not actually get that kill. Meanwhile, Slark is pursuing J4. Oh, he's got a blink out of the way in 2 seconds. Shachlo does fall in the bottom lane, and J4. Looks like he was able to get himself out just in time. The rest of Relax. They see the blast, but it's too late, man. You're not going to be able to find him.
They don't know that.
They don't know that. 17 to 19, 34 minutes in. Still over a 15,000 gold lead for Power Rangers and a 6,000 experience lead. But they're taking more map control, right? Even though the gold lead isn't really growing in their favor, they're taking more map control. They're pushing out a little bit better.
Well, they still have these tier ones up, so I wouldn't say their map control is better. But they're just playing aggressive in the enemy jungle where they can. It's just unfortunate that he got hit by the arrow there from Shachlo.
Yeah, I'm sorry. So. I meant better than it was before. Better than like 8 minutes ago when they were a little bit more locked inside their base.
Yeah, it's all because of the Aegis. They're able to push out a little bit. And Dredd's going to get picked off again here. No, nice TP away.
Cheshire Cat's going to run into Windex, but doesn't actually take the time to scythe the Bison.
FN got hit with an arrow. And Moon,
whoa.
Nice leap away.
Moon can't even turn and fight that Shadow Dance. Oh, God. FN's just going to go for the kill. Arrow. Oh, God. If only it's Shadow Dance, maybe he would have regened up enough to live through that arrow.
Brewmaster ulti's coming up here. FNG is going to get chased down. BKB's about to go off, so he's going to be going down here.
At the same time, Windex is going to get picked off. Shell Grape only saving for so long. We do see Bane going down on the side. We also have the Timbersaw. He's going to run into Slark here. He wants to battle up the Slark. Why not? Moon's going to join him as well. Has to play the distance game. Oh, no, he's going to be locked down. He's actually going to get popped real quickly. BKB goes off, but there's still enough physical damage to hold him in place. Scandal does what he can to try and finish off these heroes. Dredd will go down. Now Timber chains away as the rest of Relax are coming in. J4 gets held in place. Timbersaw trying to do what he can. Shiva's, oh, and a beautiful play there from J4 with a nice blinding light. And the complete miss on the pounce means that J4, whoa, that was a poor blink, but he's still going to be able to get out because Slark not looking for more. But yeah, look at that. Relax now. Dyer's able to get so aggressive they can push into the tier 1 towers. They may actually be able to take one or two in the next couple minutes. But the problem is Cheshire Cat still split push away.
Yep, split push is real. It's hard. It's Fury on ulti. They're not pushing out the lanes. They're just diving heroes on these side maps. So if they were like killing heroes in the middle lane or the side lane here, they could be killing. But since they're fighting in this river area, they're not pushing out the lanes, and this just gives Cheshire Cat a lot of room just to be split pushing, making them come back. So, very unfortunate them. Like, I was going to talk about this a little bit ago. Maelstrom picked up on the Mirana, so she realizes that she needs more DPS, and if they can get the Mjolnir on there, Windex, you should be fine.
Scandal, man. He's dealing with all five of these heroes. He's not going to be able to Chamber Chain away. Epicenter being used this time. Dread made the mistake last time where he did not use the Epicenter, and Dread was able to get away. This time around, he makes sure that guy's dead.
Oh, FN is going to die here. He's dead.
Yep. Fiend's Grip goes down with the recall going out from Moon. They have the follow-up arrow. Plus, they've got Cheshire Cat on the side also beating him down.
I'm so sad right now. There was five heroes on the Timbersaw, and none of them picked up the gem. Cheshire Cat just TP'd in and picked it up. That is...
really?
That is facepalm worthy. Later. So very unfortunate there from Relax. They could have had a gem. And do they have buyback on Slark? No, yes. No, no, no. 173 gold required. Go back to our tower. Go relax.
I don't think they're going to be able to, man. They have to stick around and fight this fight. Tier 3 tower is going to go down. They cannot stop beating on the racks, but it looks like Relax are... well, I was going to say it looks like they were going to try and initiate without the Slark, but Power Rangers actually backed themselves away. Don't want the fight.
That's kind of curious too, why they didn't go there. They have two lives essentially on the Timbersaw. Can buy back. You have buyback on Potom. You have buyback on Kato as well. You have so many buybacks. You can recall once you buy back, or once you die. You can TP back in with Furion. You can TP back in with bots on the Timbersaw. They had like 8 or 9 lives there, and that was the biggest. I don't want to say pansy play, but it is a. I think they just. Too safe in that situation, but they're still up, so they don't want to just throw their lead away.
Yeah. Oh, I totally agree. They are not really in a position to be able to just sit here and lollygag about. Like, the Slark is eventually going to be a big threat. Like, as soon as he gets the Abyssal, any hero that he locks down, excluding maybe Scandal, just because Scandal by himself is so damn tanky. But any other hero, if he gets the pounce off, they're dead. Because by the time the bounce goes away, they've gotten a couple of bashes. You can even use the active if necessary. The Slark's going to be a big threat for them, but Power Rangers still playing the better movement game as they're just constantly keeping Relax on their toes with all this split push.
Oh, Sand King has a BKB now, and Centaur's going to be going for one too. So if they can get some BKBs, that'll negate a lot of magic damage from Power Rangers' side, but Timbersaw, he's going to be going for that Sheep Stick. So they're going to have a lot of possibilities, along with Nature's Prophet, about to pick up his MKB.
Oh, that mana leak, so annoying for Slark. He has to actually accept the arrow there. Arrow lands on him. Shallgrave was used earlier by Windex, which just means he's not going to be able to use it to save himself. Timbershane eliminates him while the Slark goes down
on the side. No buyback either.
Yeah.
That's it. I don't know. There's no way back into this. That's their only damage dealer.
Agreed. That should be the Midrax going down. The Mjolnir picked up by the... by the Mirana. That should be mid racks, possibly even a second set of racks within that 64 seconds. Somehow Relax have to force a fight with only three heroes. It's all their big team fight ultimate heroes, but it's still not going to be enough.
Yeah. One last, I don't know, what do I say, coup de grace, big bang, they have to do it. They need to defend. So if you lose two racks, it's going to come back.
Arrow. Oh, Shotchel actually intercepts it for Yoki to make sure he's able to get off his ultimate. Dread. Oh my god, he's going to die. He still gets off the epicenter at the time, but the physical damage just cleaned him up real quickly. Brewmaster does get off his ultimate, but they just turn, fight the Brewlings. It's Brewlings by themselves. They don't really do a whole lot. Not anymore, Anthony. Power Rangers, second set of racks going down, and Relax, they just... Really, they just haven't called the GG yet. That's what it comes down to.
Yeah, no mercy, Power Rangers. Well played by them. Godlike for Yoki. He's 9-0. He ended the game 9-0 on the losing team.
Wow.
But
that's impressive.
That's pretty amazing, but I don't think his micro was up to, you know, some of the other Panda players.
Agreed.
So I wasn't impressed by his play, even though he was 9-0. That's why I was like, whoa. Well, this is not too bad from him.
All right, guys. Well, that is just game one in this best of three between Power Rangers and Relax. Well played by Power Rangers. Doing a great job going into game one. I think we didn't give them as much credit for the early game, and they just did a generally good job just snowballing. They didn't try and push in too early. They didn't try and force any bad fights. They just controlled the map really well, continued to get those pickoffs. And gotta say, Scandal's Timbersaw just somehow built into the tankiest of all tanks. So well played by Power Rangers. That's just game one, though. Stick around, guys. Game two coming up next.